So over here we've got the old gas generator that came out, that was installed before. And over to there, that's the new gas generator that will be going in. They're both exactly the same. This is a Rolls-Royce Olympus gas generator. It's what's fitted, well, it's a marinized version of what's fitted to Concorde or the Vulcan bomber. When we run it, we get about 25,000 shaft horsepower out of it. The cost of it, we reckon it costs probably about in excess of £1 million. They're not brand new anymore, they'll be reconditioned. This one will be going back to Rolls-Royce, and what they would do, they will probably strip it down and then renew the parts that are needed to, and then send it back out into like the Olympus pool, and then this could end up on another, either on our ship again, or it could go to a 42, which is ever ship in the Royal Navy that uses one. In normal cruising, one of these is more than sufficient to power this ship along. In fact, most of the time we only have one on. It does burn around about 110, 115 litres a minute of diesel. That's almost twice my car at home's fuel tank every minute in comparison. So, there you go. Fill that up at the pumps.
The new engine's on its way down. And these engineers can't go off shift until the job's done.
2-6, heave! Come on!
Come on, you went to your scratch, you should better shove it by now.
Yeah? Go ahead!
Well done.
And again, 2-6!
Come on, stand the power!
After a further 5 hours, the new engine is in position.
All we need to do now is just secure it in place, and then we'll just connect all the fuel pipes and to back onto the gas turbine itself, and then a couple of lads will then recommission the engine, and hopefully we'll get a run out of it and pass it back to the bridge standby. It will work first time. It will work. Yes, it will. We have confidence.
It has to, because ARC's got to get back to full strength for the task force's amphibious assault.
Vessels now ready for our first life start at the port. Outer, fuses 3 and 4 are replaced. Air start is de-isolated.
After entering SEC, CO Hinton, start us off when you're ready.
Start up.
About to start the engine. And turn the switch to fuel igniter on. It's looking for a positive rise on the TET. And we see a positive rise there. The intercooler is open, the air start is engaged.
ARC's fourth engine is back online.